फ्रेंड्स, आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज मूविंग कॉइल गैल्वेनोमीटर, विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. मूविंग कॉइल गैल्वेनोमीटर इज ए डिवाइस यूज्ड फॉर डिटेक्शन एंड मेजरमेंट ऑफ स्मॉल इलेक्ट्रिक करंट्स. मूविंग कॉइल गैल्वेनोमीटर स्मॉल इलेक्ट्रिक करंट्स को डिटेक्ट करता है और उन्हें मेजर करता है. प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मूविंग कॉइल गैल्वेनोमीटर. वर्किंग ऑफ मूविंग कॉइल गैल्वेनोमीटर इज बेस्ड ऑन द फैक्ट दैट When a current carrying coil is placed in a uniform magnetic field, then the coil experiences a torque construction. A moving coil galvanometer consists of a coil PQRS1 having large number of turns of insulated copper wire. This coil is wound over a non-magnetic metallic frame, which may be circular or rectangular. This coil PQRS1, this is suspended from a movable torsion head H by means of a phosphor bronze strip in a uniform magnetic field produced by two cylindrical pole pieces N and S. The lower end of the coil is attached to hair spring S dash. The other end of the hair spring S dash is connected to terminal T2. L is a soft iron core which may be spherical if the metallic frame is circular and which is cylindrical if the metallic frame is rectangular. This soft iron core L is so placed within the coil that coil can rotate freely without touching the iron core and pole pieces. This makes the magnetic field linked with the coil to be radial field. That is, plane of the coil in all positions remains parallel to direction of magnetic field. M is a concave mirror attached to phosphor bronze strip. This concave mirror helps to note the deflection of the coil by using lamp and scale arrangement. This movable torsion head, this is connected to terminal T1. This whole arrangement is enclosed in a non-magnetic metallic frame to avoid disturbance due to air. This frame has leveling screws at its base. This moving coil galvanometer can be connected to a circuit through terminals T1 and T2. Therefore, this is the construction of moving coil galvanometer. Now, the theory. Let L is the length, L is equal to length PQ or RS1 of the coil, and B is the breadth QR or PS1 of the coil. N is the number of turns in the coil. Now, area of each turn of the coil A is equal to length into breadth, and B is the strength of the magnetic field in which coil is suspended. I is the current passing through the coil in the direction PQRS1. Let at any instant alpha is the angle which normal drawn on the plane of the coil makes with direction of magnetic field. We know that rectangular coil carrying current, when placed in a magnetic field, this experience a torque, which is given by torque is equal to NIBA sine alpha. N is the number of turns in the coil, I is the current through the coil, B is the magnetic field in which coil is placed, A is the area of each turn of the coil, and alpha is the angle which normal drawn to the plane of the coil makes with direction of magnetic field. Now, if the magnetic field is radial, that is, plane of the coil is parallel to direction of magnetic field, then alpha is 90, therefore sine alpha is equal to sine 90 is equal to 1, therefore sine alpha is equal to sine 90 is equal to 1, therefore torque is equal to NIBA. Due to this torque, the coil rotates. Due to this torque, the coil rotates and the phosphor bronze strip gets twisted. As a result of it, a restoring torque comes into play into the phosphor bronze strip, which would try to restore the coil back to its original position. Let theta is the twist produced in the phosphor bronze strip due to rotation of the coil, and K is the restoring torque per unit twist of the phosphor bronze strip. Then total restoring torque produced is equal to K into theta. K is the restoring torque per unit twist, then the total restoring torque for theta twist will be K into theta. In equilibrium position of the coil, the deflecting torque is equal to restoring torque. Now the deflecting torque was NIBA, and the restoring torque is, total restoring torque is K theta. So in equilibrium position, deflecting torque is equal to restoring torque. Therefore, I will be equal to K theta upon NBA. Now K upon NBA, this is equal to G, which is a constant. Therefore, I is equal to G into theta. G is a constant called galvanometer constant. Therefore, I is proportional to theta. This means deflection produced is proportional to current flowing through the galvanometer. Therefore, such a galvanometer has linear scale.